Thank you. My name is Sam Fraiberger, and I'm part of the Big Data program at the World Bank. Sorry, this is moving by itself. I would like to first thank the organizers for the invitation. It's a pleasure to be part of such a great event. So let's imagine that you would like to measure optimism at a global scale. This is not a crazy idea, right? The behavioral economics literature tells us that more optimistic people tend to be more productive, firms are likely to invest and take risks, and contribute them to grow faster as a result. So it should be useful for policy to measure optimism at a global scale. Yet it's often hard to get direct measure of optimism, and there is no systematic effort to do so at a global scale. But with the rise of digital technologies and the availabilities of large repositories of unstructured data, variations in optimism leave digital traces around us, and these traces can be measured. For instance, they can be measured in what we read in the news or what we write on social media. So here I'm going to present briefly one example that started as a research project a few years ago and that we're now trying to scale within the World Bank. So I've collected all the news articles from Reuters since the 1990s. And using a combination of topics modeling and extracting geographic information from the text, I'm about to construct a sample of 4 million articles focusing on economic news and on about 25 countries. And I then measured optimism using a low-tech social scientist approach, taking dictionaries of positive and negative words and counting their occurrence in the text. So basically, I can construct an index of optimism in a given location still moving by itself, counting the fraction of positive expression focusing on a particular location at a given point in time. So what this gives me is first an index that can track fluctuation in economic activity at the country level fairly well. So here I'm showing variations in my optimism index in blue, averaged at the yearly frequency, and in GDP growth in yellow for 4 countries, that's Argentina, Malaysia, Mexico, and India. So here I'm averaging the index at the yearly frequency, yet the index is available daily. And I can actually repeat this exercise by disaggregating ever in a specific region in a country or a specific sector or both. So looking at this plot, one might wonder if a human forecaster that would look at official statistics and try to predict economic activity would do better or worse than this machine-based approach to reading the news. So to answer this question, I looked at a panel of professional forecasters that each month give a forecast of what they think GDP growth will be for a given year in a given country. So for instance, the forecasters of GDP growth in December will give a forecast of GDP that's announced in January. And if their forecast is unbiased, the sentiment index prior to the forecast should not affect the forecaster's prediction. Yet this is not what we observe. Actually, more positive news predict higher level of economic activity, controlling for the consensus forecast, meaning that the forecasters do not properly account for the information embedded in the news. So systematically measuring sentiment in the news is useful. How useful is it? Well, I find that in this prediction of GDP growth at a country level, including the news-based sentiment index, improved the forecast by about 15% across countries compared to a model using only human forecasts. So using sentiment improves the human-based model, but does not substitute and does not give a better model in itself. I will just conclude by saying that as we start using more and more unstructured data set to answer policy questions, it's of course important to think about the biases in each of these data sets, from cold detail records to Twitter messages. But it's equally important to think about how to use these sources, not in isolation, but combining them as each of the individual bias in each source may wash out in, say, an ensemble model, for instance. Thank you.